and welcome to the session. In this session, we discuss the following question that says, if log BC to the base A equal to X, log CA to the base B equal to Y, and log AB to the base C is equal to Z, prove that 1 upon X plus 1 plus 1 upon Y plus 1 plus 1 upon Z plus 1 is equal to 1. Before moving on to the solution, let's discuss some results to be used in the solution. First, we have a law of logarithm, which is log x1 x2 to the base a is equal to log x1 to the base a plus log x2 to the base a, where x1 and x2 are positive numbers. A is also a positive number, but a is not equal to 1. Then second, we have the change of base formula, according to which log n to the base a is equal to log n to the base b into log b to the base a. This is the key idea that we use for this question. Let's now move on to the solution. We are given that log bc to the base a is equal to x, log CA to the base B is equal to Y, and log AB to the base C is equal to Z. Now, we are supposed to prove that 1 upon X plus 1 plus 1 upon Y plus 1 plus 1 upon Z plus 1 is equal to 1. For this, first we consider the LHS, that is 1 upon x plus 1 plus 1 upon y plus 1 plus 1 upon z plus 1, and we substitute the values for x, y and z. So, this is equal to 1 upon log bc to the base a, that is x, plus 1 plus 1 upon y, which is log CA to the base B plus 1 plus 1 upon Z, which is log AB to the base C plus 1. Further, we have this is equal to 1 upon log BC to the base A plus, now we can write 1 as log of a to the base a. So, in the denominator here, we get both the terms, that is both the logs, with the base a plus 1 upon log c a to the base b plus, now 1 can be written as log b to the base b, since this term has the base b. So, we will write 1 as log of b to the base b plus 1 upon log ab to the base c plus 1 can be written as log c to the base c, since the base of this term is c. So, now the denominator of this first term is the sum of the logs. So, for this, we can use this key idea, which is log x1 x2 to the base a is equal to log x1 to the base a plus log x2 to the base a. So, this can be further written as 1 upon log abc to the base a plus, similarly, using the law, in the denominator of the second term, we can write this as 1 upon log ABC to the base B plus 1 upon log ABC to the base C. Now, from the change in base formula, we have log N to the base A is equal to log N to the base B into log b to the base a. on this, putting n equal to a, we get log a to the base a is equal to log a to the base b into log b to the base a. This means that 1 is equal to log a to the base b into log b to the base a, since we know that log of a to the base a is equal to 1. And from this we get log a to the base b is equal to 1 upon log b to the base a. Let this be result 1. So we use this result 1 for this MHS. So hence we get MHS is equal to now 1 upon log ABC to the base A can be written as log A to the base ABC plus 1 upon log ABC to the base B can be written as log B to the base ABC plus 1 upon log ABC to the base C can be written as log C to the base ABC. So this is using the result 1. Now again, as the LHS is the sum of the logs, so for this we will use this law of logarithm, that is log x1 x2 to the base a is equal to log x1 to the base a plus log x2 to the base a. So from this we get this is equal to log abc to the base abc, and this is equal to 1. Since we know that log of a to the base a is equal to 1, thus we have the LHS is equal to 1, which is the same as the RHS. So thus, we now have 1 upon x plus 1 plus 1 upon y plus 1 plus 1 upon z plus 1 is equal to 1. This is what we were supposed to prove. So, hence proved. So, this completes the session. Hope you have understood the solution of this question.